I was born in a Christian family. My mom and my dad were Catholics, and when they came in France, they were looking for something bigger because they had the feeling that something was missing in their lives. So they began to look for a church, and then I was born after the marriage. And they found a church in Melun, in France, a Pentecostal church. And my dad said to my mom, okay, we need to stay here because I feel something I've never felt before. Man. That was the Holy Spirit.
Hallelujah.
My dad received the Holy Spirit first, and then my mom.
Wow.
And I am in the church since I was 2. Today I'm 24. Yeah. And I was used to be in the church, and I've done everything. I've done Sunday school, I've done all the things that church can offer to children. And, you know, I went to church because it was a habit, but I haven't met Jesus yet. I met Jesus when I was 13. It was during a Sunday school, and someone from the United States came and teach about meeting Jesus. So at the first time I was like, but I already know who Jesus is, but I didn't know. It's not because you're in the church since you are 2 that you know Jesus, that you have met him. So I met Jesus when I was 13, and for me, the age of 13 is the age where I took the decision to follow him, the decision to be with him, to live for him. And my mom, you know, is a woman of prayer. She prays a lot. And she was praying for me. She was praying because my health wasn't that good when I was young. And she prayed a lot for our salvation. Because I didn't meet Jesus until the age of 13. And when I met Jesus, I felt like God telling me that what I was doing for him wasn't enough. It's not enough to come to church. It's good, but it's not enough. It's not enough to sing. It's good, but it's not enough. It's not enough to read the Bible. It's good, but it's not enough. We need to meet Jesus.
Yes.
We need Jesus in our lives.
Yes.
We need Jesus to be our partner.
Yes.
We need Jesus to be our confidence.
Yes.
We need Jesus to be our help. We need Jesus to be our savior. We need Jesus to be our salvation. And you know, my testimony isn't that much about where Jesus saved me from, because like I said, I was in the church and I knew what was wrong and what was good. But my testimony is more about what Jesus kept me from.
Yeah.
He kept me from a lot of things. My health wasn't good, but I'm still here today because of him, because of his blood that he shed for me. You know, Jesus, for me, Jesus is faithful. His faithfulness is the greatest thing I've experienced in my life. Because when I was down, he was still there. When I was up, he was still there.
Yes.
And today he is here with us.
Yes.
And I'm not perfect. I have a lot of flaws.
Yes.
But through the blood of Jesus, I am purified.
Yes.
Through his blood, I am sanctified. And through his blood, I am justified. And through his blood, I know that I am healed.
Amen.
Amen. And I would like to encourage someone here. We need to make a decision. Sometimes we are Christians. Sometimes we say we are Christians, but we didn't make that decision. The decision to follow Jesus no matter what. The decision to be with him no matter what. We need to make that decision. And as a young person, sometimes it's hard because we think that we have a lot of time before us. We think that following Jesus is easier when you are old because you know it's nearly the end. But I am 24 and my hands will be tomorrow.
She's like nearly dead.
We need to make a decision today. Maybe someone here hasn't made that decision. You just come because you like the music, you like the word of God. But please, make that decision today. We need to make the decision to be with Jesus, to stay with Him. And to finish, don't let any bad situation be between you and between Jesus. You know, when Jesus, in the New Testament, met his apostles, he said to the apostles, follow me. Let what you are doing, but follow me. And that's what he is doing today. That's what he said to everyone here today. Follow me. Just let that situation down. Let those things, let it go and follow me. Following Jesus isn't that easy, but it's worth it at the end. Because we know who he is.
Yes.
And when you know who Jesus is, you will follow him no matter what.
Yes.
And that is the decision that I made today. I made the decision to follow Jesus.
Man.
Amen. Praise God.
Praise the Lord.
My name is Luis Rissazo and I'm from Paris, France. I'm from this French group. And we are very happy, very blessed and honored to be here this afternoon.
Amen.
Praise God for that. Praise God for life that we have. Praise God to be in His presence, and I praise God for knowing the truth.
Man.
We are almost 7 billion on the earth, and I've been chosen.
Yes.
You have been chosen.
Yes.
I don't know why. I'm not better than you. Man. I'm not better than people outside the church, but God has chosen me.
Yes.
And I thank God for that.
Thank you.
I hope that everybody thinks the same, because it's a real privilege for us to be in the presence of God this afternoon. I send you all the greetings of my pastor, Brother John Novaki. He's a missionary in France. He has been a missionary for more than 40 years now. And I love him so much. And he is a great man of God. He has done a lot of things. We have now about 25 churches in France. And the church is moving forward. And you know that because you have televisions and you watch TV, you watch news, and you know that those last 3 years we've had a lot of bad situations in France, terrorist attacks and everything. But it doesn't matter what's happening in this world, the church is moving forward.
Yes.
Thank you for that.
Yes.
We are, all of us, the result of a prayer. I am the result of my father's prayer.
Yes.
My father has been praying for me every day for 5 years, and I'm now here in front of you, in the presence of God, in the church.
Yeah.
And I just want to encourage you to pray. That's something that we all know. We know that as a Christian we have to pray. We know that as a Christian prayer should be our grief, something that we do every day. But how do we pray? Do we really pray? You know, in the Bible, I was saying that yesterday to the Spanish service, there is no verse in the Bible that says that we need to be a pastor, a preacher, a minister in the church, to God for God to hear us. We just need to pray with faith. That's all. That's all it is. And prayer works.
Yes.
It works. It has worked for me. And once again, we all are the result of prayer. Jesus prayed for us. Jesus prayed for us.
Amen.
And He gave His life for us. And what I want to do is now give my life to God.
Amen.
God loves us. He loves you. He loves me. And I'm very glad to be here once again. As a church, at the end of times, it is our responsibility to be in prayer. It is our responsibility to pray for people around us, our families, our friends,
yes,
and for this world. You know, the devil is not sleeping, he's not resting, he's working. So the church needs to work. We also need to do it. So may God bless you. It's once again my privilege to be here with all of my friends, and I already feel at home.
Amen.
The presence of God is my home. It will be my home forever. So I enjoy my God's presence. God bless you all.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
Amen. That was pretty good for another church, but I'm at Living Hope of D.C. I said, praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
I want everybody under the sound of my voice to stand up to your feet, lift up your hands right now. Hallelujah, Jesus. God, we worship you. You're awesome. You're wonderful. God, there's no one like you. We give you praise. Come on, let me hope you can do better than that. I know you can do better than that. We're in the church of the living God. We're in the presence of the living God that loves delivering you, that loves set you free, that God heals you. So we really have a testimony in the building. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Woo!
Well, I am excited, Brother Staley, to be in Living Hope of D.C.
He came and stayed with us last year.
I'm excited about what God's going to do here.
Hallelujah.
Amen. I've been blessed today to get to travel around with my friends from France and get to learn a little bit about their country. And we've had a little Q&A, and I hope that our friendship continues.
Amen.
Amen. And if, were you not blessed by that worship?
Hallelujah.
Many of you know my name is Dylan, and I'm from Oklahoma. I just graduated Bible College about back in May.
Hallelujah!
And last summer I spent the summer out here, and I gotta tell you, it was one of the most blessed summers I've had since I've been living for the Lord.
Amen.
It's absolutely a blessing.
Jesus.
I'm so glad to see Brother Paul Lee and Sister Lee and their
beautiful.
Last time I was here, you guys.
Yes.
Praise God. You guys are blessed. Wow, to have Brother Lee and Sister Lee here. Praise God. That's awesome. Well, I am graduated from Bible College, and now I'm about to go on a missionary journey to Austria for 3 months.
Wow.
And that's going to start in September. And I want you to know, if I was not going, I would be here.
Amen.
This is the place to be.
Amen. Hallelujah.
I just want to share something with you that I read in prayer this morning. The Lord woke me up and I had a dream. The Lord gave me a dream. I know it was from the Lord because, you know, when you get a dream and you just feel that was from God. Amen. I was in this dream. I was just out in a field and there was a bunch of believers together. They're all praying and worshiping. And it became something fanatic. I mean, people were just running around, jumping, just shouting and worshiping. And I mean, their arms were flailing all over the place. And I just was like, my goodness, this is incredible.
Yeah.
And God says, this is the kind of revival that I want to send to the earth, where it's not just in a house or in a building, but it's out on the streets. It's all over the place. Without anybody taking control. And I just wanted to encourage you. I feel like the greatest revival that wants to come to D.C. is about to come.
Hallelujah.
This is the church that's going to receive that revival. Amen.
The church is so big.
Amen. You believe it? I'm going to live in hope of the church. Woo! We need to have the greatest revival in the city of D.C. Amen. Praise God. I love each and every one of you, and I hope to get to see you and fellowship with you after the service. God bless you.
Amen.
Pleasure to have Dylan back with us today. didn't know it was coming. But I've had, over the years, we have had a great number of interns come from all over the country. And I will tell you, don't tell any of them, but Dylan was undoubtedly the greatest.
Amen.
He had such a servant's heart.
Yes.
And he didn't have to be told to do things. He looked for things to do.
Amen.
And if you're ever in leadership, you know what a difference that can make. Mm-hmm. If somebody is looking for something to do,
yes,
instead of just having to follow directions. Amen.
Amen.
Would you stand? And we've had more folks come in. We're glad you're here.
Amen.
I'm going to get us a Spanish translator here. And if you would, again, one more time, and go to somebody and greet them. I'm going to speak just a few minutes, but we have more guests.